I've made up my mind, I'm done being sober. 8 months, it's officially over. I'm done with this boulder, this tie around my neck. They said I'd be happy if I finished my steps, but it ain't come yet. I'm on step six, still sitting here fiending for that fix. Them first 30 days, I was hungry and broken. The fire was out, now I'm distant and lonesome. Phone is a ghost, I ain't getting no calls. I'm positive, nobody's caring at all. So today is the day that I'm catching the buzz. I've only been good at fucking things up. I'm stuck in a rut, I just got my kid back. I'm working a job, I've been making an impact on all of the damage I did in the past. So why am I stuck in this place that I'm at? There's a rain cloud that always seems to follow me around. Got the devil on my shoulder, he been saying things aloud like, Matt, why you even sober anymore? You've been crying out to God, but the prayer's been ignored. You're all by yourself, so I've opened a door. Step right inside, I got what you've been looking for. Dude's got a pack that he only wants 24. Just send a text, what you got all that money for? Spend it, blow it, burn it to the ground. You already know you're gonna let your people down. Your kid would be so much better if you were not around. You deserve to be 6 feet under and dead inside the ground. Point made, okay, hear you loud and clear. I'm a go cop. Today, I'ma send a text right now. I really gave my best, but I guess I'm all out.
What are you doing?
I'm getting high.
Why would you do that? What if you died?
I'm still feeling sick. I guess it's goodbye. It's not getting better, and I really tried.
What about your daughter? Aren't you her father?
She's better off without me. I don't know why I bothered.
Look, shut up and listen. I'm done with your bitching. I'll give you some truth about the price of addiction. Picture your family over your grave and your mother in black with the tears on her face. Rewind it a couple of days when you're back on the block and you're copping a bundle to taste. Crying and shaking and know that you're giving up everything just for a giant mistake. You pull in the alleyway, flick on the light, get your spoon in the lighter and park with the brake. Picture the rush and the prick of the blood, the guilt that you feel with the fleeting euphoria. Blacking out, dying, the flash of the EMT lights, getting tagged on your feet by the coroner. Fast forward several weeks, your family and friends can't believe it, it's heavy and bleak. Your daughter is coping with knowing her father is not coming back and she's desperate and weak. Your girlfriend is broken and hopeless and searching for reasons for losing the man that she loves. She can't sleep at night when she pictures the bag being zipped by a sterilized hand with a glove. You plan a vacation for later this year, but you took a trip that she didn't expect. And now her last memory of you is your skin turning blue with a 30 gauge rig in your neck. And all of the people that you made amends with who finally started to give you respect are shaking their heads and they're saying you wasted your talent and calling it gift and neglect. And let's not forget all the people you thought were your friends you got high with and shiesty connect. Your homies all dying a week after copping the same dope. Their life is a check. He's cashing while laughing and smoking a blunt up in traffic or bagging up bundles to package, cause he doesn't care about your family or daughter. He's killing 10 people monthly on average. Some will accuse you of being a liar, an addict, a criminal, savage, or thief, but most will just see it as tragic. Your daughter and mom lost their son and their dad in the street. Your relapse is bigger than how you feel now, bigger than all of your fear and your cravings. If you start slipping, you'll empty the souls of your family. You won't just empty your savings. Remember that even on bad days, your life is a gift and sobriety saved you. And a relapse can take away everything good in your life and the chance that it gave you.